Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Catholic Mass from St. Patrick's Catholic Community in Scottsdale, Arizona. I'm Father Eric Tejas, the pastor of the parish. Along here with me today is our deacon, Joel Herrera. We welcome you to this liturgy on the sixth Sunday of the Easter season, but also a special blessing today as our country honors all our moms. Whether they're alive here with us or they've risen with the Lord, we have a special blessing after the homily today to pray for all mothers today. Paul, our gathering song for this, the Easter season.
God so loved the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
The Church has just this very interesting way that we begin the liturgy, that we call to mind our sins. It's not because we're negative. It's not because then we're just so ashamed and that God only sees us at sin. But rather, it really allows us to praise God for mercy, that resurrection is the forgiveness of sins, that it is healing from sinful ways in our lives. And so we don't just approach it negatively, that we're just unworthy and we're so full of shame, but rather we praise God to say, God, we thank you for your willingness to heal us, and we cooperate with that by calling to mind our sins and trusting in the resurrection power of Jesus' healing.
Lord Jesus, you lay down your life for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you free us from the slavery of sin. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us to love one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Joining God's people throughout the world now, we join in the singing of the glory.
Father, you take us.
Let us pray. We gather all our prayers into one. Loving God, we pray that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Let us now be attentive to God's word.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up. I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear him speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. You have made known your salvation and revealed your justice to all. Remembered your kindness and your faithfulness to all, to the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Shout joyfully to God, to the Lord all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so also I love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I call you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not I who chose you. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What a beautiful gospel. It is one of my favorites. And that line is just unbelievable. No one has greater love than to lay down one's life for one's own friend. What if you and I were to make a list of people that we would put on the list that we would lay down our lives for? Maybe as parents, we might do that with our spouses, maybe with our children, maybe people that we've encountered who become our neighbors or good friends. Maybe even in that list, believe it or not, could be strangers that we meet that in an emergency situation, we have somehow been able to lay down our life and risked it for other people. And so that list that I would make, and I think you would too, would obviously be people that I would say, I do love, and I do want it to be that way. And that list, you know, has a certain amount of names. But I don't know if we would really be able to say clearly that we would add more people than we could ever imagine on that list. And yet, isn't that what Christians are called? Even Jesus tells us in the scriptures that if we love people who simply love us back, what good is that? He says even pagans do as much. But he gives us the command today to love one another. And again, remember, love doesn't mean that emotional feeling that we might have for people that we really care about and have a deep relationship with, but rather the love that says, I want what is good for you. And that's the commandment that Jesus gives us. My command is to love one another. And if Christians really took that seriously, I think more people would believe in Christ and participate in the life of the community. And that's the challenge that we have to call ourselves in order to be able to love as Jesus commands. Now, for me, I value relationships of people that I find are maybe challenging to love, but yet I still love them. And what I practice in my life, and maybe you do, you may not call it that way, but I've learned to lay aside any disagreements I have with people. I have special friends in my life, special relationships with people who, you know, to be honest with you, have a different view than the gospel of Jesus. There might be an area in their life where, you know, they don't agree. Maybe it's public that how they live their life is not in line with what the gospel or maybe even our Catholic faith teaches. You know, maybe I'm not agreeing with them politically or socially. And they may do things in their lives that disappoint me, that kind of make me want to pull back and say, ooh, that's not what I want my friends to be. And yet, I am so grateful for those relationships because when I lay aside those kind of things, I see people really trying to do their best. That if I solely just focus on that shortcoming and say, gee, you really are not living what the church teaches. You're not living the gospel that I've been preaching, that I've given my life to, and you kind of dismissed it. And you don't agree with my homily or my conversation with you. But I find out that I fall in love with those people because they do other things well. They're friends that I have that are wonderful parents. Even if I disagree or not like something that's going on in their lives, man, I mean, they're outstanding parents or outstanding beautiful children towards their parents. People who really are generous, even if I don't agree with them on things and maybe not like the particular area or a set of areas, they're there at the soup kitchen. They're there being so generous. And so what I've learned to do is to give people the benefit of the doubt is laying aside differences, disagreements, things that I clash with or may not like in people, in order to fulfill the command that Jesus says. The commandment is this: love one another as I have loved you. Not every friend of mine, not every person I encounter agrees everything of the gospel. And you know, that happens in life, and even in my life, we have blind spots. But I've learned to continue to love them and not disown them, not create an isolation or a wall that says, until you solve that one problem that I see in you, then I will love you or invite you or make you feel welcome. Jesus tells us something very interesting. I no longer call you slaves. Because a slave doesn't know what a master's about. Instead, I call you friends because I've revealed to you everything I've learned from my Father. How many times do you and I live in slavery? Slavery to resentment in relationships. Slavery to allowing that disagreement to say, we no longer speak to one another, we no longer like one another, I no longer want to deal with you. Slavery to disunity and division. That I disagree with you so much that I've labeled you and I've pushed you aside and say, you can't be part of what is part of the group that I've determined is the right way to live. And we live as slaves because we won't be open to being friends with Christ. And I think we see that quite often. I grieve with you who have family members who aren't talking to one another, or friends and neighbors that you have decided that you no longer see eye to eye with and choose not to be with them. Sometimes those things can be very serious, and we understand that. But Jesus still asks us, what ways can we lay aside? whether the relationship can continue on, or maybe we learn to love them in a new way that still honors them and respects them. And if Christians could really do that better, I mean, I have to be honest with you. I always read about churches starting these new programs and new devotions and a new way of praying. You know, in my short time, I've seen a lot of them. And I don't know if they all work. Some do. But you know what? If Christians really loved one another, I think we would see different life in our Christian communities. If we need proof, just look at the Acts of the Apostles. They had no structure. They didn't have church times. They didn't have beautiful buildings. They simply went out with the grace of God and the Holy Spirit and loved one another. And the church grew in that time. And we can recapture that again. Maybe that's what the pandemic might really call us to do better in the church. That if we could lay aside those things that we clash with and are in conflict with or do not like in other people, doesn't mean that you accept that and go, well, that's just the way it is. No, the hope is that people can convert and change. And some of my friends have, simply because I didn't cut them off, didn't judge them in a way that really says you're less than and you are not on my list to love and care for. That happens a lot. And we remain slaves to our own ignorance, our own inability to look beyond things that are immediate to see the goodness in people. And if Christians could really do that better, we wouldn't need all these programs. Just simply loving. And I think the scriptures back my assertion because there's so much evidence in that. And so today, think about all our relationships. First of all, our mothers that we honor today. Think about the moms that maybe in your relationship, maybe you had the blessing of a mother that really did lay down her life, whatever way that was, in placing you first or helping you grow and believing in you and loving you and caring for you. We should honor those kind of relationships because they're out there. And we need to bless, ask God's blessing upon them. And so we're grateful for those who have had mothers or have mothers now that they feel that beautiful love. For others, it might be a difficult challenge. And maybe today could be, again, another day that we lay aside anything that might keep our relationship with our mothers being fulfilled or fruitful or loving. And maybe we can do that a little bit. Anything that we have to set aside because there was disagreement or hurt feelings, whether they're alive or not, wherever we're at in relationship, God embraces that. And God loves that. Because in some of my friends that don't agree with everything our church teaches or the gospel, they have other gifts that just blow me away. And maybe the same thing is with our mother. Maybe they had shortcomings in one area. Maybe there was clashing and disagreement and hurt. But maybe there were other areas in their life that they did well, whether you know about them or not. And so to all mothers who are watching today, we just honor you as always, but especially today. And we're going to offer you a blessing in just a moment. But to all of you who have loved ones that you have on that list that you would lay down your lives for, let's thank God for those people. But let's also be willing to lay aside anything that keeps us from loving people fully as Jesus commands. Not being stuck in slavery, but being called friends of God. And at this time, if there's mothers there that are watching, you could stand if you wish, if you're surrounded by family members. And, you know, one of the most ancient signs in Christianity is when one extends their hands over another to offer a blessing. So if your mothers are there or you want to pray over them through online, you're welcome to do that now by extending your hand as we offer this Mother's Day blessings to all mothers, those who are moms by giving birth to children, those who have adopted or are foster parents. Maybe you're a motherly role and given that title by someone you care about. You're all included in this today, in today's prayer, and we pray for you and your role as a mother and guide. Loving God, you are the author of life and goodness. On this special day of honor, graciously pour out your blessing upon all mothers and women in mothering roles. May our community always be a place of welcome for mothers and families. Help us to become instruments of your love and compassion as we build a culture of life and a civilization of love, together with all people of goodwill. To the praise and glory of your name, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Congratulations, mothers, and we love you this day and we honor you. Just a couple of announcements that would be very important to let those watching online know what's going on. There is a Mother's Day blessing card that's available for you online, as you can download it and print cards as well. And if you happen to come to the Mass or Communion on this Sunday, you're also welcome to pick up cards that are available for you. Our annual water drive will take place this month online. You can make your donations on our website, and we will purchase the water bottles and get them delivered to the City of Phoenix cooling station. Thanks for helping us reach our record goal last year of 320,000 bottles. And we're ready to welcome any new returning hospitality ministers and other ministers of the liturgy there. Please call the parish office for more information. As more and more people are feeling safe to come back, we're ready to keep moving forward and be able to serve the people who come to our liturgies on Sunday. My friends, we can stand, and at this time, we're going to renew our baptismal promises, the promise to reject sin and to profess our faith in Jesus Christ. Please respond, I do, to these questions. My friends, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of being God's children?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. May God make us strong in living this faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The commandment from Jesus is to love one another. We show our love always through the prayers of the faithful.
That those searching for faith in a chaotic world will encounter Christ in every member of the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders around the world find ways to bring an end to war and violence and promote peace and development for all nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That mothers everywhere may recognize the gift of their children and nurture them with joy, and that God will watch over them. Bless them with every good gift and fill their hearts with peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are gathered here at St. Patrick Catholic Community, in person and online, may see the face of Jesus in one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That students, as they finish the semester, stay focused, clearly express what they have learned, and find life-giving activities for the summer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer illness of any type may be restored to health and be given hope in the Lord. Sue O'Meara, and that those who have died, particularly those who from COVID-19, will be welcomed by the angels and saints into the fullness of life with the Lord. Elizabeth Healy, Mary Polito, Melissa Culver-Hine, Maureen Hillebrand, we pray, will be welcomed by the angels and saints into the fullness of life with the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Not only those petitions mentioned out loud, but all the petitions deep within the hearts of everyone through this liturgy today. Answer our request always according to your compassionate way. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now we move to the liturgy of the Eucharist.
I give to you to love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice, the sacrifice of ourselves, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us truly give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks and at all times to acclaim you, Lord, but in this Easter season above all, to laud you more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He is the true Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise as we join in that unending hymn of praise. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death that he freely accepted, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread, giving it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, again giving you thanks and praise, giving it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving chalice, giving thanks that you have counted us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, his assistant bishop, and all who serve your holy people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Let us remember everyone throughout the world who has died as a result of COVID. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that together with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages, may we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray as one family in the words that Jesus gives us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us the fruits of this Paschal sacrament and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. A sad day for us, as today we will say goodbye to Jill Bagshaw, who's been with us in our parish as a staff member for about 10 years and has done many things, but most especially we are grateful to her to guide our liturgies during this COVID time. She was a godsend for us, very organized, very on top of it, and engaging, and really has saw us through some really challenges. But she has a new opportunity with Life Teen through the EDGE program, which, by the way, was started here at St. Patrick's 25 years ago or so. So, but we wish her well, and we thank her and her family as she gets into a new position, and we're very thankful for what you've done and very excited for your continued gifts to the church. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Let the people say amen.